suspected Arewa lab will share a repair case for an iPhone 14 Pro that failed to turn on. Long press the phone's power button, but it cannot boot up. Connect the charging cable. The phone still can't turn on. Disassemble the phone. And disconnect the battery flex cable. When the power cord is connected, there is a high current before the phone is turned on. The motherboard is short circuit. First, we need to check three main power supply circuits, BATTVCC, PPVDD main, and PPVDD boost. Check the BATTVCC position on the bitmap. The multimeter measurement circuit is normal. Continue to measure the PPVDD main circuit and find that the circuit is short circuit. According to the bitmap, the PPVDD main circuit has associated components on both the logic board and the signal board. Further troubleshooting PPVDD main with thermal. First, remove the motherboard and place it under the infrared thermal camera. The temperature in the middle of the motherboard was abnormal after powering the motherboard PPVDD main. Check abnormal temperature areas with the bitmap. The motherboard needs to be checked separately. Brush with PCB cleaner to assist in removing the protective foam. Use a hot air gun to heat and remove the thermal sticker on the back. Fix the motherboard on the desoldering platform and heat it with 170 Celsius. Pry up the motherboard with a 360 Celsius hot air gun. Remove the logic board and signal board. Remove the thermal grease. The PPVDD main circuit failure may occur on the logic board or on the signal board. Test the logic board circuit and find it short circuit. Upon powering the logic board PPVDD main circuit, we find the temperature of the power IC location rises. Let's take a look at a malfunction part. It seems there are burning and cracks on the power IC. Next, we need to replace a new power IC. Use the hot air gun with 340 Celsius to remove the power IC's edge glue. Then use a hot air gun and a sculpture knife to remove the power IC. Add a little solder flux and medium temperature tin. Then use a soldering iron at 380 Celsius to neutralize the pad's melting point. Use a soldering iron and a solder wick to remove the tin. Clean the pads using a brush dipped in PCB cleaner. Repair damaged components around the power IC. Apply a small amount of solder flux to the power IC pads and heat with a hot air gun. Take a reballed power IC. And check the bitmap to ensure that the power IC is positioned in the correct direction. After aligning the pins, use a hot air gun to heat and solder the IC. Use the multimeter to test the PPVDD main circuit again. And the diode value is normal. Process the middle layer pads of the signal board and logic board. and then install the signal board and logic board into the motherboard layered test fixture. Connect the screen and the power cord. And now we can turn on the phone. Now reball the signal board. Apply a layer of low temperature solder paste evenly. And then heat the signal board on the heating platform at 170 Celsius. Apply flux paste to the pads after the solder balls are formed and the motherboard has cooled. Align the logic board and continue heating. After recombination, cool down the motherboard with a dust cleaning air gun. Attach the protective foam to the motherboard and the thermal sticker to the back. Install the motherboard to the phone. The phone can be turned on. Functions test is normal. In motherboard repair, desoldering and soldering power IC can be challenging. In addition to learning how to troubleshoot, technicians also need professional operating skills. To learn more, please visit academy.rewa.tech. Comment below to share your thoughts. Thank you for watching.